The Philippine Court of Appeals clears Japanese billionaire Kazuo Okada of fraud charges. It reversed a lower court's decision that found reason to put Okada and another associate on trial for allegedly misappropriating $3.16 million from a casino resort operator where he was CEO. The CA said the lower court acted with grave abuse of discretion because the case filed by Tiger Leisure, the operator of the Okada Manila Integrated Casino Resort, lacked probable cause. Tiger Leisure had accused the Japanese gaming mogul of illegally disbursing millions of dollars during his tenure as CEO for his consultancy work and salaries. Okada has denied the allegations. The Philippines appeals to Indonesia to lift its ban on coal exports. Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi cites the healthy economic cooperation between the two countries in making the plea. He says Indonesia's policy will be detrimental to economies reliant on coal, like the Philippines. Cusi adds the Philippines sourced 2.3 million metric tons of coal from Indonesia last year to fuel its power plants. Indonesia ordered the month-long ban this January as it seeks to avert a looming power crisis there. The city of Manila extends a deadline for the renewal of business permits and payments of property taxes amid the latest COVID surge. Manila Mayor Isko Moreno announced the deadline for payment of business permits is now until March 31, while tax payments will still be accepted beyond January 20th. Transactions can be coursed through the city government's website and through payment systems available at SM San Lazaro and SM Manila. Moreno says the deadline extension was prompted by requests from the business community who expressed apprehension in doing physical transactions amid rising COVID-19 infections. Mayors in the capital region believe there's no need for a higher alert level yet, despite the rapid increase in COVID cases. A former Philippine health secretary even says shifting to alert level 4 now wouldn't do much at this point.
For the meantime, we will maintain alert level 3. We will continuously monitor specifically the HCUR kung ano mangyayari rito. At kung kinakailangang dalhin sa alert level 4 at any time, papasok po namin.
The positivity rate is just too high that I don't think there's very much government can do at this point as far as restrictions are concerned and things like those. It's really up to us to wear our tight-fitting masks, to make sure we don't go to congested, not well-ventilated areas, and to make sure we are clean in general.
Well, Malacanang earlier said it will only raise Metro Manila to alert level 4 once the region's healthcare utilization rate reaches the threshold of more than 70%. Well, the Foreign Affairs Department suspends the operations of several consular offices amid a surge in COVID cases among personnel. Our correspondent Liza Aquino filed this report.
Due to the steep rise in COVID-19 cases among its personnel, the Department of Foreign Affairs will temporarily suspend the operations of some of its offices from January 10 until January 20. According to the agency, they will temporarily suspend their services from some of their consular offices, its Office of Consular Affairs or OCA, and temporary off-site passport services. There will be skeleton teams at all sites while the rest of the workforce will work remotely during the temporary suspension of operations. Because of this, no passport or apostille applications will be processed or released during this period. Operations shall resume on January 21. They are advising all affected applicants to directly contact the consular office where they filed their application for an inquiry regarding this matter. An email will also be sent to them regarding the adjustment of schedules. For emergency cases, however, the department will endeavor to provide assistance within its limited capacity during the temporary closure. You may reach them at 8234-3488 or 8651-9400.
Well, airline operations in the Philippines also affected by the country's COVID surge. Airline officials say fewer staff are reporting to work, leading to flight cancellations. 30 domestic flights have been canceled by Cebu Pacific until the end of January. Philippine Airlines says it called off 80 domestic and 6 international flights. AirAsia also reporting that their flights from January 6 to 31 have been affected by the surge in COVID-19 cases. The airline companies say affected passengers may request for refunds or rebooking of their flights.